What's going on, everybody? It's our last day at Animal Kingdom, and it's gonna be a sad one. I'm about to go on Everest here. We'll see how it goes. Stay tuned for the rest of this review.
First day was at Magic Kingdom. I was super nervous and didn't know what to expect, but she told me that we'd start on Tron, which was super fun, and I fully recommend it. And then we saw a guy that looked like Johnny Depp, and we had to take a picture with him.
And make sure you get those Mickey waffles.
And after walking almost 9 miles that day, we began to sit down and prepare for the fireworks show. I had no idea what to expect. Well worth the wait, well worth the headache, and well worth scrapping knees and elbows with the people who are right next to you. I cannot fully recommend this one enough. Day two was Epcot, aka Drinking Around the World, and boy was I excited because normally I'm just drinking Busch Light, so having a chance to have a beer from Germany or Ireland was so cool to me. And I was super excited for Space 220 that would be coming up next. And that was going to be our later on dinner, and I was so stoked because I'm a big, big space guy. Also Star Wars, but just in general, big astronomy nerd. I know. After getting launched into space, boy was I hungry, and boy do I mean I was hungry. So I had to make sure I was going to get that $55 worth. So I ordered the Wagyu beef and the New York strip, aka steak and fries. And at the very end, you get the good old photo op. Another must-do at Disney World is making sure you hit up that aquarium. Because I've never seen a manatee before, but I'm about ready to go save all of them because they are so gosh darn cute. Day 3 was Blizzard Beach, aka our chill day. Shout out Matt the bartender. Later on that night, we hit up Planet Hollywood, and I recommend the primetime American Kobe. Day 4 was Hollywood Studios, definitely the one I was most stoked for. Again, I mentioned I was a Star Wars geek, so I was definitely stoked. And I got to pilot the Millennium Falcon. Yes, I was definitely geeking out just as much as you would imagine. After that, we hit up Oga's Cantina, and we had some good old drinks there. I had a fuzzy tauntaun, and ooh, was it so good. Makes your mouth numb, and it's definitely an experience, but I would fully recommend it. Next up on the list is to make sure we said hi to Woody and the gang, so I made sure we were going to take a picture with good old Buzz, too. He yelled at me for wearing a Space Ranger outfit, but hey, I don't know what to tell him. It was from a different galaxy, so it is what it is. Then we met Chip and Dale, and they were so cute. Had the warmest little hugs you could ever little imagine. Not as cool as Goofy. We kind of dapped up, but I guess that's just personal bias. After walking over 10 miles, I was definitely ready for some food. So we went to Woody's Roundup Rodeo Barbecue, and boy, was it good. Definitely recommend with going for 4 people because it is a lot of food.
$24? Come on, Disney, we're better than this.
Somehow the wife convinced me to go on Tower of Terror, and boy, was I scared. I was scared. Day 5, we went to Animal Kingdom, and it was everything that I expected. A lot of screaming kids and a lot of big animals. Super, super cool. I definitely recommend the safari, and definitely recommend going and hitting up the gorilla hike. We did miss the tiger trail, but it is what it is. But there's so much to see, so much to do. I think you truly can't do like everything you want unless you're gonna stay there for like over a week. I don't know, maybe that's just personal bias. Another underrated spot is Rafiki's Planet Watch, aka the Wildlife Express. You get to pet a bunch of animals, you get to draw some stuff, and you get to see the behind the scenes of what they're doing here at good old Animal Kingdom. Sorry in advance, I'd like to take videos and pictures of little baby monkeys and gorillas, so I had to make sure they got their shout out here in this video. And look at that badonk, my goodness gracious. I also had to take several pictures of this cute meerkat. My favorite parts of Animal Kingdom was definitely Pandora. It was absolutely beautiful and stunning. We did not get a chance to see it at night, but I'm sure it would have been breathtaking. While in Pandora, make sure you hit up the Avatar Flight of Passage. It is absolutely nuts. It's breathtaking. It's everything you'd imagine. I can't give you any more details than that because it's just too much. You have to experience it for yourself. I would also recommend Setuli Canteen. You can make your own bowl, as well as they got these cheeseburger steam pods. Ooh-wee, are they good, as well as those splash margaritas. You're going to want one of those, trust me.
Next up on your to-do list is make sure you hit the Festival of the Lion King. It is definitely going to be worth it.
The wife got to watch Beauty and the Beast, and I got to watch the Lion King, so I guess I would say that both parties were happy. After the show, it was time to hit up Expedition Everest, and I was a little bit scared, I'm not going to lie, because I knew it was going to kind of go backwards, but I was definitely ready for something a little bit more spicy. Another restaurant to make sure you try is Flame Tree Barbecue. Ooh-wee, I'm a big onion ring guy, so I was already sold at that, but the baked mac and cheese with pork was so good, as well as that bubbling pink lagoon and rum island breeze. Ooh-wee, but if you don't get that meal plan, look at the price at the bottom. Oh my god. Next up is a little All-Star Movies Resort tour. They have the world premiere food court, which has so many offerings for food. I'm sure you can find something that will trick your trigger, as well as a Fantasia-themed pool. Yes, it's pretty cool, and it's perfect for kids. Another cool thing about All-Stars Movies Resort, it's got 101 Dalmatians themed, as well as Mighty Ducks. Yes, the Mighty Ducks. I was not able to get that on video, but hey, who doesn't like 101 Dalmatians? They also have two pools to choose from, so you can either go in the Fantasia themed one or the Mighty Ducks. I always chose the Mighty Ducks. Here we go. Oh, you're not happy. We're leaving.
I know, I'm sad.
Well, it's a little dirty in here, but just want to show her off. Not too shabby, not too shabby. Very affordable options. Everything you could ever need. One of my only complaints was these hospital pillows. They were bad. I'm sorry, Disney, but you gotta be better than this. You gotta. Lastly, I recommend those magic bands because they certainly got a bunch of benefits. They unlock your door, they allow you to pay for things, control your meal plan, as well as hit those interactive rides that everyone wants to do. I fully recommend Walt Disney World, and I thank you for watching, and make sure you visit there the next time that you're in Florida.